initiatives, including legislative initiatives, aimed at curbing corruption, starting from the responsibilities of the public officials. So the legislation prepared by this government, that this minister refers to, is a clear testimony of the sincere intentions on the part of the government to bring about a change. Illicit enrichment, a very important matter, which we as the European Union mentioned in our dialogue with the government many years before. Now we can see a very serious action to prevent illicit enrichment. Then the strengthening of the responsibilities of the Ethics Commission, including the importance of the asset and income declaration. Again, this government realized that it's not enough to have a system when you bear no consequences for non-submission of your income and asset. We have witnessed very concrete action on the part of this government. We are aware of the further plans and intentions, including the work on the establishment of the independent anti-corruption agency. I can tell you very openly that in our dialogue with the Armenian authorities the last years, we have tried to convince that this would be a good solution for Armenia. And finally, we have a partner which says, yes, we agree, it would be a good solution. And of course, the discussion is not easy. I know that there are different models in Europe, and here in Armenia there are different views, what kind of competences, what kind of roles this agency should have. But at least we can say that there is no dispute concerning the usefulness of having such an agency. And again, this government is very serious on introducing throughout the legislation the concept of the conflict of interest. Again, I can refer that in our previous conversations over the years, we also pointed out as the European Union that for Armenia would be good to define the conflict of interest and to undertake very serious measures, because we believe Armenia would profit a lot from separating politics from business and for making very clear that conflict of interest is bad. So I can only confirm what Mr. Minister said, that this is not only about words, that we have seen very concrete action on the part of the government. But you are hinting at the fact that what we need is serious implementation. Not only acts, legislative acts, laws, but serious implementation. And therefore, we are launching this campaign together in order to make this process further develop and consolidate through the process of implementation. As Mr. Zadrian said, implementation necessitates public support. Implementation necessitates the recognition of non-acceptance of corruption. So, with the public pressure, we can be optimistic about the implementation. And that's the whole purpose of this campaign. Our role as the European Union is a supportive role. We are ready to continue providing financial means. As you know, we have allocated so far more than 15 million euros in support of the fight against corruption, and we are ready to continue our support throughout different initiatives with the government, budget support, but also with the civil society. We try to balance it very carefully. So we believe that we can be optimistic. We want to be optimistic as the European Union that 2017 will bring a change. It is not fair to say that the previous governments were not doing anything, because I can say that there were people in the government who have been very active to we introduce this type of initiatives and measures. So this is not a totally new start. Probably Armenia needed the time to assemble the critical mass, both in the political elites and the wide circles of the population. But we want to see this critical mass being transformed into concrete action, because this would be very good for Armenia.
Thank you.